Hello, Mabel. Will your mother and you be home this weekend?
Hello, Nicole. How are things going? We shall be gone for a while, but Sunday night, we will return home.
Sunday night only? Really?
Yes, we have plans to attend yoga starting on Friday night. That has been in the works for a while.
Really? Yoga? It sounds wonderful. I'm envious of you so much. What area are you planning to visit?
We've been wanting to get away together for quite a while. We want to go on a trip to several cities to have fun and do yoga in different places on the way.
Nonetheless, that sounds wonderful. Do you think I can join you? Because I won't have any commitments after Friday afternoon. I also require pampering. Calvin will come a little bit late because he's coming home on Friday night, but he can still join us so we can celebrate a little. There will only be the two of us gals until he arrives. How exciting this will be!
Yes, but our bookings are just for two individuals for two nights and they were previously made.
Never mind about it. Without a doubt, there won't be any issues. Just be sure to keep quiet while we are there. The front desk won't see us. We simply need to sneak in.
I have a feeling that you'll be exposed. Now hold on. Do you mean to say that my mother and I should share a room with you? Don't you at least make an effort to reserve your own room?
It will be quite expensive to reserve an additional room. After all, we had to take out a loan to cover the whole cost of our wedding and honeymoon. You are aware of his salary, aren't you? Definitely not enough to swiftly pay off our bills.
As if I'm aware of my brother's income. I am clueless.
Nevertheless, disregard that. If we all travel together, I won't need to visit you on Sunday night. With this move, I'll be able to accomplish two goals at once. So I guess that settles it.
I apologize, but the reservation is truly just for two individuals. I have to pay if I bring two extra persons. You must make your own reservations if you are truly interested in going. Do you want the phone number?
We don't have the funds for it, as I already informed you.
In response to your original query, do you require our assistance this weekend for anything specific?
Oh yeah, that's correct. We still have some gifts to give you from our honeymoon.
Gifts from honeymoon? If my memory serves me correctly, it was more than 6 months ago.
Sure, it is correct. Although Calvin finds it quite difficult to take time off work, we ultimately had a terrific time. We wish to show you lots of pictures and give you these mementos. Calvin doesn't have any scheduled shifts this weekend, so we figured it would be the ideal opportunity to get together and share stories.
If that is the case, it would be nice to catch up with you then, as we will be home on Sunday evening.
Meeting on Sunday is not a good idea. I really want Calvin to be able to get some rest before he needs to go to work on Monday. On Sundays, he often prefers to relax at home all day.
That sounds so much like Calvin. He's been like that for the longest time. He rarely left the house on Sunday afternoons or evenings when he was living at home either.
It's fine for me. I have no problem going out on Sundays or even staying out till really late at night.
Yes, I understand the situation. After all, you are a full-time housewife. So the demands on your time are not so strict, are they?
You got me there. But you know, there's only so much housework that can be done in a limited place like our apartment. Anyway, back to my point. I really want to give you these souvenirs and talk to you about some things. Are you sure we can't join you at yoga?
I see no problem with you joining us, but like I said, you have to reserve a room for yourselves.
And like I said, we don't have the money for that, so that's not going to happen.
Yeah, okay, so we both agree that you are not going to be joining us. Surely you realize that sneaking into a room without booking or paying is against the rules and tantamount to stealing.
Well, then, how about next weekend?
Let me see. Next weekend, I'll be free to see you on Sunday in the morning.
What? Again? Only on Sundays?
Yeah, I'm sorry, but again, my mother and I both have plans on Saturday and Sunday afternoon.
Okay, well, I will check with Calvin what his plans are, and if it looks doable, we will go on Sunday morning to give you these souvenirs. You better keep your schedule free for us.
No problems. By the way, you said you wanted to talk about something. Is anything wrong?
Well, it's sort of urgent, but I guess it's nothing that can't wait until next week. It will be better to talk to you in person anyway. Hey, now that I think about it, if we're going there on Sunday morning, why don't we have lunch together? If I remember correctly, there's a fantastic little sushi place near your house. I'm pretty sure they do deliveries. What do you think about that?
Yes, there is a place and they do deliver.
Fantastic. Can you make the order for us and make sure to order the super large set, the one with octopus?
Getting that set for 4 people would be a little bit pricey. Are you sure you're okay with that?
No problems at all. After all, we will be the guest at your house, so we are looking forward to you treating us.
Hang on a moment. Are you suggesting that I have to pay for your lunch?
Absolutely. I don't know why you need to ask that question. We are the guests in your house, so it's natural that you pay. Maybe you can ask your mother to pay for it. I'm sure there's still plenty of money left over from your father's will. Surely she has no financial problems at the moment. It will be no problem at all for her to pay.
Well, first of all, maybe you have forgotten, but my mother is not a big fan of sushi.
And your point is?
Well, don't you think it's a little strange to ask someone who doesn't like sushi to make an order for sushi, pay for it, and then not be able to eat any of it?
I don't think it's strange at all. After all, she is inviting us into her house. The least she can do is give us some good old-fashioned hospitality.
I'm sorry to have to break it to you, but we actually have plans for lunch, so we're not going to be able to eat together.
That's okay. Just order enough for Calvin and myself.
It'll all rely on Mom's schedule, so I'll have to inquire.
No issue there. Please let me know when you think is the ideal time.
Mabel, how thrifty are your mother and you? We travel all that distance to see you, yet all you do is offer us tea and cookies? Given that you and Nicole spoke at length about food for a week ago, we are fully anticipating sushi.
I have no idea what you're talking about. You must be aware that Mother dislikes sushi, so why would you insist that we get a special lunch package for you two?
Surely, she should be able to welcome us as guests and provide some simple hospitality.
Perhaps if you want to be treated as a guest, you should have a little more respect for the house owner's wishes. After all, we did tell you we had plans for noon. And what time did you end up arriving? And then to have the nerve to demand we provide you lunch, and hang around arguing the point until afternoon when you knew we already had plans to go out.
Yeah, and in the end, we got thrown out of the house. How rude is that?
Yeah, totally. And on top of that, you said you had some souvenirs from your honeymoon and some other things that you wanted to discuss. Then you almost ran out of time to give us the souvenirs. How rude of us. And while I'm at it, the souvenirs were just fridge magnets. And you never did talk about what you wanted to discuss. I don't even know if there was a real reason why you had to come and see us so urgently. I suspect that you just wanted someone to buy you lunch. Am I wrong?
We were just hoping to have some food on the table while we had a little discussion. You know, It's easier to negotiate on a full stomach.
Negotiate? What is it that you wanted to negotiate?
You know, we wanted to discuss you and Mom giving us ownership of that house.
I'm sorry, that's a little bit sudden. What brought this on?
Well, you see, the thing is, Nicole is pregnant.
Pregnant? Don't you think that should be the first thing you mentioned before any of this other stuff?
Yeah, well, anyway, the place we are renting now is only for 2 people. If we have a child, we'll have no choice but to move out. I'm sure you can imagine, but it's going to cost a lot of money to have a baby.
Yes, I can see how that would require a bit of money. But how does that equate to us giving you ownership to this house?
Don't you see it? I'm the oldest son, so that gives me the rights to the house. Now that Dad has passed away, I'm the oldest male in the household, so it's my birthright to take over the house.
Yeah, I don't think that's right.
Of course it's right. I'm the man of the house now. Since Dad's gone, I'm going to get what's coming to me.
That's a little bit sudden, don't you think? After all, this house is not yours, nor is your name on any of the legal paperwork.
I'll leave that part to Mum. It should be no problem. After all, it's her first grandchild. She's definitely going to be happy to give me control of the house when she realizes that. The lease is up for renewal on our current place next month. So we'll simply not renew and move in there. I mean, it's going to be so much easier to move before the baby is born, don't you agree?
Next month? You expect to move in here on such short notice? How can you go ahead with such planning without even discussing it with us in the first place? Sure, you don't expect us to find a new place and move in that same amount of time, do you?
Yeah, surely there's no problem with that. After all, you're still single, so it's easy for you to move. Mum's still got heaps of money from Dad's will, so she'll have no problem paying for a new place.
Regardless of the fact that you are her son, you are not allowed to say or do certain things. This is definitely over the top.
I wanted to let you know that whether you like it or not, we're moving next month. I anticipate you will take care of this small favor for us, since it will be Mum's first grandchild and your first niece or nephew. That's what we intended to talk about. Can you let Mum know what's going on?
Hold on. You can't send me a message with such a significant announcement and then expect me to relay it. This one needs to be completed by you, alone in person. Calvin, you must be the one to tell your mother this.
Hello, Mabel. Have you and your mother already chosen when you'll move out?
Nicole, a heartfelt congrats on your pregnancy. We were overjoyed to hear it all. Of course, we want to throw a great party for you and celebrate, which is why we won't be leaving.
After this kid, we intend to have another baby, or two, so we definitely need a bigger place to live. Of course, we won't be able to just buy a huge house on Calvin's wages. Just securing a bank loan to pay a deposit will be difficult. Even a little 3-bedroom house in the middle of nowhere costs too much for us.
I hear what you're saying, but your financial problems have nothing to do with me.
Ever since I got married to Calvin, I truly believed that one day his family home would also become my home.
Since you got married?
We are both in our 30s now, as you are aware. The body's ancient clock is going off. I desire a home, a family, and a happy, healthy life for everyone. I need to get moving immediately since I don't have much time to spend.
Do you realize that giving birth costs a lot of money, right? Not only that, you need a lot of money to actually raise a child and properly educate them too. If you're not able to build a house on Calvin's salary, do you think you will have enough money to raise a large family?
That will be fine. There's no worry there. After all, seeing as how we won't have to pay rent, or purchase the house. We can put all of Calvin's salary into raising our family.
What? Am I to understand that you have no intention to pay anything for this house?
Well, naturally we will pay the appropriate taxes as required, seeing as how it's going to become Calvin's house.
Is that so? I see.
Yeah, Mabel, you really should think about getting married soon. After all, your father passed away 2 years ago now, right? It's time you found a new man for your life now that he is gone. And then you can forget about all of the memories left in that old house. Leave the past in the past.
You are so desperate to move into this house, aren't you?
Absolutely. Naturally, I want to live in a big house, but I really don't want to live. Who is my mother-in-law? That would be terrible. I'd have no freedom at all. I just want you guys to hurry up and move out as soon as you can. Is that too much to ask?
Fine, we'll move out.
Thank you, I'm so lucky.
You said next month, right? Is the end of next month okay with you?
I prefer if you could move out before that.
Finding a new location will take some time. I must work throughout the day as well, so I can't spend a lot of time searching.
Ugh, okay. I anticipate you to honor your commitment. Mabel, can you take the call? I've been attempting to contact your mother via phone, but I can't reach her.
Well, your mother has banned your and Calvin's phone numbers. To be quite honest, I'm the one who set up the block for her.
Why would you act that way?
I was under the impression that you wanted nothing to do with her anymore. So really, you should have no reason to call her anyway.
But it's an emergency. I really need to talk to her.
An emergency? What's wrong?
Calvin and I just moved into the house. And it's totally empty. There's absolutely nothing here.
Yes, that's right. When we moved out, we took all the furniture and appliances with us. The things we didn't need, we sold.
What? No, that can't be true. You can't do that. You mean you took the fridge? How can we be expected to live?
What are you talking about? Didn't you bring all of the appliances and furniture from your house when you moved? Normally, that's what people do. They bring their things with them. That's why it's called moving.
All the things in our old place were items that Calvin had from his bachelor days. It was all old and breaking, so we ended up throwing most of it away. Almost everything, it was all old. This new house had all brand new appliances.
Are you saying that you expected us to move out of the house and leave all of the furnishing and appliances there? What were we supposed to do when we moved into our new place?
When we discussed taking over this house, we meant we wanted everything that was inside of it too.
That's the first I've heard of that. In fact, I've never heard anyone being so demanding. Ever.
But how are we going to live?
That seems rather simple to me. You can just go to the shops and purchase the things you need.
There's no way we can afford that. Brand new appliances are very expensive. The whole reason we had you guys move out of here was because we had no money.
Well then, that's gonna make things really tough for you. Now that you have to pay $2,500 a month in rent.
What? $2,500 in rent? A month?
That's right. Didn't Calvin tell you about that bit?
Calvin says he doesn't know what you're talking about.
He doesn't? Well, in the meeting with the real estate agent just 2 weeks ago, in which Calvin was present, the part was definitely explained in detail. Calvin should have the documents in his possession. Anyway, it's not our fault or problem that he wasn't paying attention to the meeting. The paperwork has been signed, the official renters of the property have been changed to you and Calvin. There is nothing more we can do about it.
Official renters of the property? What are you talking about? You make it sound like we are simply renting the house now?
What are you talking about? We've always been renting this house. We moved here when Calvin and I were still in primary school, and I've been renting it ever since.
Renting?
Yes, that's right. The original owner of the house was my father's brother. In other words, my uncle. But my uncle is so busy with work that he's hardly ever in the country. Sometimes he's back for a few days, but that's about all. He didn't want to sell the house, but he let my father live in it to keep it in good condition. But he still expected rent to be paid for it.
Oh yeah, as well as a set time that he would allow us to stay here.
A set time to stay there?
Yes, that's right. He only wanted us to stay here until it was time for him to retire. When he retired, he planned to settle back down into the house.
No way. You're lying right now, aren't you? Are you meaning to say, when is he planning to retire?
Next spring.
Next spring? That's less than a year away.
Yes, I know. That's why I knew we had to move out at some point in time anyway. Mom has been pretty busy trying to find just the right place to move into. One of the reasons we have been traveling around and staying west to check out some different areas that we might like to move to. After all, Mom likes yoga. So, it was a good excuse to go and visit some.
Hang on, so you mean to say you've been paying $2,500? If we have to pay $2,500 in rent, that's almost all of Calvin's monthly salary gone!
Well, no, we weren't paying $2,500 for rent. Part of the deal was that if we looked after the house and the surrounding area too, and kept it very clean and tidy, we only had to pay $900 a month.
$900? Well, we will also look after the house and keep the area around it clean and tidy. We want the same deal.
That's not up to me to decide. After all, my uncle doesn't really trust Calvin very much. After all, uncle is aware of how this transaction has gone down and doesn't seem too impressed by it.
So you're saying that because your uncle doesn't trust Calvin, we will have to pay $2,500 in rent?
When you consider the house's size and location, you'll see that $2,500 is actually rather affordable. Also, if you are careless and unable to maintain the house tidy, you will probably be required to cover any damages out of your own money. It was included in the agreement. Whoever was residing there when the harm occurred would have to pay for any damages. We wanted the real estate agent to explain everything to you in detail before any contracts were signed. Since we had a suspicion that you and Calvin didn't know we were renting the property. But it seems that after receiving the right explanation, you were still unable to comprehend the issue.
Well, where is Mom living now?
I'm not going to tell you.
Is she staying with you? Did you move somewhere together? If you're living together, why don't we all live together in your new place?
I seem to recall you saying once that you did not want to live with your mother-in-law, that you couldn't stand it.
Yes, but now that I've had time to think about it, this is my first child. I can really do with some sound advice from an experienced mother. I really think it would be better if she was there for me.
My mother is not a servant to be used as you wish.
But it's her first grandchild. Surely she would want to help, or she could.
Mom has blocked you and Calvin from contacting her. I'm pretty sure that constitutes her answer to your question.
So what do you expect me to do from now on? How am I gonna live?
Thing that you and your husband are going to have to figure out by yourselves. Not that it's important, but no. I'm not living with my mother.
You're not? Then where are you?
I'm not going to tell you that either. But if you really must know, I've moved in with my boyfriend.
Boyfriend? You have a boyfriend?
Yes, well, you could call him a boyfriend. Perhaps it would be more correct to call him my fiancé. We decided to move in together so that we can start preparing for our life together.
Are you for real?
Yes. At the end of the day, Uncle was planning on coming home next spring, so I had to move out anyway. Everything sort of just fell into place. I asked my fiancé what we should do, and he agreed this is the path we should take. It just happened a little bit faster than expected. Every day is a wonderful day. I am so happy. And I guess I have you to thank for all this.
But my future looks so bleak right now.
My brother got married to you a year after our father passed away 2 years ago. To be really honest, I was also thinking that I needed to have a family right away. Once I get married, my last name will change. And after that, you and my brother won't hear from me again. This feels like the most appropriate approach to terminate our relationship for good.
You don't want to say something you'll later regret? Without you in our life, I can't even imagine to picture what it would be like. Please think again. Don't leave your family in such a way!
My brother and sister-in-law were immediately blacklisted on my phone following that conversation. I'm genuinely unaware of their relationship at this point. I did learn, however, that they were unable to make their rent payments, and after 3 months of not doing so, they were kicked out of the house. Although my uncle had first insisted that the house be taken care of and kept clean and orderly, he was obliged to focus on collecting the overdue rent before anything else. My brother is probably not very well off. Therefore, there is no way they could afford to move to a new house. I have a feeling they could have returned to Nicole's parents' home in order to make ends meet. I'm very sure they're both working as hard as they can to try to make ends meet. Now that their child has been born, I certainly hope that is the case.